So today we discuss in this Power BI course date and time calculation in the Power BI data. So last time we discussed the two categories, first the logical category, second the text category, and today is the date and time formula category. So when you first understand ki we have the date in the columns, first know ki this is actually date format or another format. So first select your date column and go to the data type. Data type have the date data type, then okay. And you also change the format, this type of the here formats. Which type of the format you can want to show. So this is the date format. But sometimes we have know about the calculations for that. Just like I want to create the summary month wise. I want to create a summary month wise. But how can some create the summary month wise? When you have on the data and we have select the this data bar, this visualizations, and we have put the date in the here and put the value is the also. So you can see here you can see that in the date it is the year wise. So the data is the year wise, but you can change here, click here and change the double here on this data. You get quarter wise, again change the month wise. But I don't want to dislike the facilities. I want to only for normal date month wise reports. I can't have this facility. You can change the quarterly, yearly, and monthly and date wise. Do you understand, sir? What is the problem?
Yeah. You cannot drill down more.
Okay. Huh. So that time we have calculated the month here. Calculate the month in the Power BI data sets. So this is the date. So we have new column. And we have write the month here and type here month. You want to in the number format that we have select the month here and date. And your data in the month format, in the number format. Okay. But you want to data in the number format, no need to the month formula. You can directly apply the date here. When you select the date column, you then this is the features which you want to show: date, day, month, month number, quarter, quarter number, and year. When you select the month, you can give the month in the text. When you select the month number, give the month in the numbers. Okay. Some mistake here. We have I wrongly put the dot here. Okay, didn't buy. And when you select the month number, give the month in the month numbers. So that time we have go to the visualization and select here. Or next week my system is upgraded, change the systems, and that time my system is not process slow. We have booked our parts, just like SSD, RAM, and other things. And there is the quantity. Put the quantity. You can show them, and here is the no options to change the month to quarter. Okay.
Yeah.
So you can calculate the date according to you, but I
from here you cannot see the year wise.
If you want to see the year wise, so select the year here. year. Press the enter. Your data convert in the year, and then you can change the data in the year by year. This is the year yearly report. Okay.
Now, if you want all this means during the presentation, if they are asking, let's see the year wise. Then they may ask, okay, let's see the quarterly performance. After that, they may even say, let's see it monthly. So if it comes like that, is it possible?
Yeah, if you want to, we have the two problem. If you want to change, you see the monthly, you want to see the yearly. If you, when you want to change, that time we use the direct date column. So select the visualizations here. One second. Select here and put the date column. No, what is it? The date column here. And the quantity. So see is the your yearly report, but you want to change, just click here downside and click here, your report will be changed. Quarterly. Again click here, monthly, again change the date wise. When you want to upgrade, click the upgrade, then we have click here. This is the monthly. So when you put the date in the date column in the your axis, that time you have the facility to change your monthly and yearly type of data. Okay, sir.
Yeah.
But I do want to not these features. You want to the fix yearly. It means yearly. Nobody change here. Monthly is monthly. Nobody change here. That time we have used the new columns and apply the formula. Okay.
Yeah.
And you can also change the calculation type here. It's like this is the sum. This is the sum of the total. You have selected value field and do the calculation. This is the maximum, average, minimum, maximum count, standard deviations, variances, median, and show value as is the percentage of the grant total. So do you want to the percentage, the contribution, percentage of the contributions? January, what total sale is, it means total is the 100. If you have 25 sale in the January, it means 25% is the contribution in the January. That time you can use here percentage of grant total. When you click the percentage of grant total, you can see here data in the percentage wise, but percentage not so. So go to the your formats and show data types, data levels here. Okay. It is clear, sir?
Yeah.
Any questions?
No.
Okay.
So one question is that it's not related to this one, but once you make this graph, is there any way to export it as a graph?
Hey, do you want to export the graph?
Yeah.
If you have, you can also export the graph. If you have the PPT, just publish your report and you go to the web console and export it on the PPT, and you have the licensed version of the your pro version of the Power BI. You can also export on the Excel, but need to publish and log in the your web console.
Okay.
So back to the topics, we have discussed the formula. Go to the formula and here is the year, but I want to, when you select the month, this is the month, this month is the give the month completely month, January February the full letter, month number give you the month, quarter give the quarter, and quarter number is the give the quarter. If you select the quarter, then show the Q1, Q2, Q4, right? But you have select the quarter numbers, then give the quarter in the number format 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, sir.
Okay.
So when you call your date column, you have the facility which part, if you want to show which part of the date, date, day, month, month number, quarter, yeah, year. But you have the more, it's just like month is the short form, just like Jan, Feb, day. You want to show the day in the Sunday, Monday, as per your recording, which recording you want. That time we use the format formula. You're right, format formula. So we have applied the format formula. In the format formula, select the date. Select the date and we apply the format. Just like I want to month in the short, then short month. So apply the triple M here and paste here. You have select the Jan, Feb, March. Just like a format formula, just like a custom formatting. In the Excel, we have used the custom formatting. Same custom formatting code you can enter here. Just like I want to the day, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, like the day. Then we have apply here triple D. Okay?
Yeah.
And now I want to add the symptom. Just like we have the 20 days, the 20 days is the period. So I want to calculate the due date. So this is the, in case this is the billing date. So I want to calculate the due date. Due date is the after 20 days of the your purchase date. Right?
Yeah.
So that time we have just plus on the date. Just plus of the date, 20. You can show here. After 20 days, you can show here. You can also minus, you have the minus. But I want to the month. So if you have purchase, if you have the purchase, this which date, next one, same date have the due date. It's like you have purchased the 5 August, then your due date is the 5 September. So I want to add not a day, I want to add the month. So you can also add the month in the Excel. In this Excel, we have used the e-date formula. So same here, you have apply e-date formula and select the date here. The date, and we have the one. Right, the one. So next month, same days which have shown. So you have want to apply the date here, you can show also date here. But problem is that no, if you have applied by any billing date in the month and the due date is the next month 26th. Just like I have purchased the 10th of August, but my billing date is the 26th of the September. So you one to one your billing cycle. 1 to 31st is your billing cycle. We have purchased any date in the month, but my due date is the next month 26th day. So that time we have applied the formula date formula, right? So we have the type year, but year is year. So select the date here. So no need to apply year formula, you can also extract the year here. Then month, so we have applied the formula date here. And no need to apply month formula, select the date and select the month number. Remember, select the month number. If you select the month is the character, and that time we have not give the calculation in the your character months. So we have plus the one. And 26 is the fixed day. Click here 26. You can see here ki every month 26 due dates. Like here. So this is the 5 January, but 26 February is the due date. 9 January, February 26 is the. Then we have the March. This is February, then March. So you can also apply the date formula here. This clear, sir?
Yeah.
So if you want to add the year, I want to after 2 year, you can plus here year. But here is some problem. I want to the due date is the next month end of the month. Just like I have purchased in the January, so due date is the February, end of the February. So that time we have used the formula EO month formula, end of the month. EO month formula, select the date. Select the date and we have just month is the one. You have the 2 month, 2, 3 month, 3. If you have the back of the month, to give the minus 1. So this is the last date. You calculate the last date of the your calendar. Okay.
Yeah.
But problem is that I want to calculate the first date of the month. Okay. Okay. We have right here 10th February, 10th January, but show the 1st January. We have right here 10th March, so the 1st March. So how can? Same thing, we have give the minus 1. When you give the minus 1, you can show here the last date of the last month. Just like, this is the January, so we have 31st December. So we have just plus the last date of the last month, you can get the first date of the this month. Okay, Mr. Krishnan?
Yeah.
Any doubts?
No.
You can calculate here easily, just like date formats. Okay. But okay. I want to calculate the difference. I want to calculate the difference because we have we have the due dates and we have the dates. I want to calculate the number of month. If I want to calculate number of day, just the latest date minus oldest date. Latest date filled minus oldest date. In the days, difference in the dates. But I want to different in the month. So that time we have applied the formula date DIF.
Okay.
So date DIF and select the date your, the date is the your start date, due date is the start date, because lower date you can select it here, and end date of the date, and this is the interval. Do you want to day, hour, minute, month, what? I want to the month, select the month, enter here, you can see here your difference in the month. You want to day, you can select your day, you want to quarter, select the select your quarter. So which interval you select, you have get the result here. Right, sir? But I have just normal calculation here. Due minus date, right? This is the your difference number of days. But I want to difference the number of days in the network days. My Saturday Sunday my company is off. So can I apply the network days here? No, network days formula not here. In the Excel we have the network days, but in the Power BI no have the network days, no have the work day, no have the weekday. The weekday has a formula. You can select the weekday. No have the work day. We have the next formula. If you select the next day, give the next day, next month, give the next month, next quarter, give the next quarter, next year, give the next year. Okay? This is the next interval. You have to select this, like we have select the next quarter and select the date here. So we have give the date the next quarter date. Oh, we have the problem. other problem here. The table of multiple values supported their single expression. Oh, this is the not column formula. This is the formula. This is the normal formula. Measures calculations. Give the result only for one result. Here. Okay. So this formula used in the just like sum x formula, count x formula, the some data summarization formula we have used the next part. Next formula, right? Okay. Is it out, Mr. Krishnan?
No.
So we have calculated the date calculations. This is the date formula. You can also apply formula date. This is the date add formula. You have add the any interval in the date. Just like date add formula, we have select the date here and number of interval you can enter here. Just like we have the write 3 and which 3? 3 month, 3 year, 3 quarter. If you select the month, then after 3 month formula is given here. Just like e-date formula. E-date formula give the only for the month. You can enter the month, but date add formula have a facility. You have add the according you month, year, quarter, anything here. Okay, Mr. Krishnan?
Yeah.
So date add formula, you can add here any type of formula. I have also the date if. This is the date between. So return the, this is the measures formula. You have return the date between given dates. We have the number of dates in the 2 periods. You can select here date formula. So this is the table formula. Okay, I have to give the example here. So the table tools, the new tables. Right. We have right here Jan. So we have give the formula date between, select the dates. That and this is the start date. We have give the 1/1/20 and end date is the 1/31/20. Problem here. Date here 2020, comma 1, comma 1, and here is the end date. Date formula 2020, 1. You can see it. You can see the result here in the different table. So when you use this feature of the formula, when you learn the data summarization formula, just like sum if, sum x, like the formula. Okay?
Yeah.
So the date between and also date period, you can also apply the formula here, date period. So we have entered the date in the inverted comma, so not accepted, because if you have entered the date in the inverted comma, then call the text, not convert in the date. So we have used the date formula here. ओके मिस्टर कृष्णन, सो नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट यू कि प्लीज यूज योर एक्सेल फॉर्मूला. लास्ट टाइम वी हैव डिस्कस ऑन द डेट एंड टाइम कैलकुलेशन इन द एक्सेल. सो फर्स्ट यू हैव डेट एक्सेल डेट फॉर्मूला लिस्ट यू हैव इम्प्लीमेंट इन द पावर बी आई. एंड यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम इन द पावर बी आई लोड द लिस्ट एंड टुमोरो वी विल डिस्कस. ओके so today you can just apply your date formula which you have learned in the Excel. And tomorrow we discuss the date and time intelligence formula and finish the date and time formula calculations. And next week we have moved to next category.
Okay,
bye. See you tomorrow same time.
Okay,
bye.